बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलामुअलैकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, क्लास नाइन्थ बायोलॉजी। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ न्यू चैप्टर, दैट इज़ सेल्स एंड टिश्यूज़, चैप्टर नंबर 4 ऑफ योर बुक। जिस तरह से हमने पिछले चैप्टर्स के अंदर शॉर्ट क्वेश्चंस, एमसीक्यूज़ और लॉन्ग क्वेश्चंस को डिस्कस किया, सेम उसी तरह से इस चैप्टर के अंदर हम लोग शॉर्ट क्वेश्चंस, एमसीक्यूज़ और लॉन्ग क्वेश्चंस जो एग्ज़ामिनेशन के अंदर सिलेक्ट किए जाते हैं उनको पढ़ेंगे। सबसे पहले हम देखते हैं जो हमारा पहला टॉपिक है, दैट टॉपिक इज़ माइक्रोस्कोपी एंड द इमर्जेंस ऑफ सेल थ्योरी। इस टॉपिक में इंतहाई शुरू के ऊपर एक डेफिनेशन मौजूद है, दैट डेफिनेशन इज माइक्रोस्कोपी। दैट डेफिनेशन कैन बी सिलेक्टेड एज शॉर्ट क्वेश्चन इन द एग्जामिनेशन, एंड माइक्रोस्कोपी इज द यूज ऑफ माइक्रोस्कोप इज नोन एज माइक्रोस्कोपी। एंड अदर short question which can be selected is magnification and resolution or resolving power. The question may be asked as define magnification or define resolving power or resolution. That may also be asked as differentiate between magnification and resolution. So magnification is the increase in the apparent size of object and it is important factor in microscopy, while the resolving power or resolution is the measure of clarity of an image. So that is the difference between magnification and resolution. There are some MCQs. The first MCQ can be, the first compound microscope was developed by Johnson in Holland in 1595 and its magnification range was 3x to 9x. All organisms are composed of cells. There are two types of organisms, one composed of a single cell and other of many cells. The next question is, what is the resolution of a human eye? Human naked eye can differentiate between two points which are at least 0.1 millimeter apart. This is known as the resolution of human eye. And the next question on this page is, what is micrograph? A micrograph is the photograph taken through a microscope, that is called micrograph. There are some MCQs. The first one is indicated here, that is about the resolution of human eye, and that is 0.1 millimeter. If we place 0.5 millimeter apart the two objects, will human eye be able to differentiate? No, the human eye would not be able to differentiate these points. The next one is magnification and resolution can be increased with the help of lenses. The next one is types of microscope. There are two types of microscope, light microscope and electron microscope. Light microscope works by passing visible light through the specimen. Now the page which you are seeing, it is mostly selected for MCQs in the examination. If there is a microscope with a reading of 109x, what does it mean? It means it can magnify 109 times. The other MCQs is, light microscope can magnify objects 1500 times. A light microscope can magnify 1500 times, and without blurness its magnification may be 1500x. Resolving power of a light microscope is 0.2 micrometer, and it is the size of a smallest bacterium. The MCQs may be asked, what is the size of smallest bacterium? And it is near to 0.2 millimeter. The page which you are seeing, there are three red signs showing the three types of short questions. The first one is about the transmission electron microscope, and the other is scanning electron microscope. Question may be asked, differentiate between transmission electron microscope and scanning electron microscope. So the difference is, in TEM, transmission electron microscope, electrons are transmitted through the specimen. TEM used to study the internal cell structure. And about SEM, we will discuss on the next page. Then, for the movement of bacteria, which kind of microscope is better? If we want to study the movement of bacteria, then we should study it with the help of light microscope. There are some MCQs. In electron microscope, beam of electron is pass through the object. Electron microscope have a higher resolving power than light microscope, and the resolving power of electron microscope is 0.2 nanometer, and electron microscope can magnify an object 250,000 times. And this page is a continuity of the last page with reference to types of electron microscope. We discussed TEM on the previous page, and on this page we can see SEM. In SEM, electrons are reflected from a metal coated surfaces. SEM is used to study the structure of cell surfaces. And there is a question which you can see on the top, and that can also be asked in the examination. So students, we have discussed the first part of chapter number 4, cells and tissues, with reference to the selection of different categories of questions. In the next topic, we shall discuss again chapter number 4, the next part number 2. Till then, Allah Hafiz.